So, okay, Sahitya,
Yes.
you have been practicing in dental clinic also,
Yes.
and also you have been the part of internship after your dental degree in some hospital. So you just describe your or tell me about your clinical experiences.
Sir, I have worked for 1.5 years in a private clinic here in Chennai. So in the clinic, I was given responsibilities of patient care, like routine dental treatments, like extraction, root canal filling, root canals, and general fillings for cavities, scaling, and all that. Apart from this patient care, I was also held responsible for taking care of the case sheets. In case any patient comes, we have to file the case sheets, and in case of any multiple appointments, we should keep on updating the case sheets for further reference. Case sheet maintenance, and also I was dealing with the payments because most of the time my senior dentist was not in the clinic, so I was solely managing and dealing with the payments with the patients and making appointments for any consultants who used to come to our clinic, and also management of the consumables because there are many dental materials in the clinic which keeps we need to keep on changing it every time because it is not like a non-consumable thing which will be there for throughout the year or throughout the clinical setup. Many like powders, cements, all these have to be managed timely consumables, looking to when we need it, how much to be taken. So I was looking into all these things.
Okay, so if मतलब why do you see मतलब why do you want to go for health administration as a course?
Sir, as a clinician, I only treat a very few number of patients who comes to my clinic or a hospital. But a public health professional can touch the life of every individual in one or the other way. So this triggered my interest during the last years of my BDS to use this clinical knowledge and expand my career to work in a larger population. But for this to work in a larger area, apart from medical knowledge, I need other skills like in economics, technology, with health legislation, management. So this public health program, I realized that this public health program clubs all the fields together to make it comprehensive. And so I realized, okay, fine, I decided that I can choose my career in this way so that I can work in a larger population, assessing the health needs and to plan and monitor the health of a broader population.
Okay, so what are the other options that you have applied for in this?
Master's in Hospital Administration and Master's of Public Health and Social Epidemiology.
And what is the preference order?
First is Master's in Hospital Administration, second Health Administration, and third Social Epidemiology.
Can you give me the reason why you have kept your preferences in this order?
Yes, sir. My very first preference for me was Hospital Administration because I have always been fascinated to work in an to look at the organizational side, apart from clinical, because that is also very important for delivering of healthcare, a non-clinical organizational side. So I wanted to learn that, and also in order to go in accordance with my long-term goals of setting up a hospital and all, I thought administration will give me that insight into managing a large organization. And also after setting up a hospital, I want to reach make outreach services like establishing an expansion of services to people who are underprivileged and do and where there are scarcity of services. So health administration also gives me the skill that is required to manage an organization, looking after management of health services. And apart from that, I will be given, I mean, also an insight into the healthcare where there is scarcity, how to take these health services among masses of public. So health administration will teach me all this in, apart from organization. And social epidemiology, any very, very first step in administration or managing is data. We need data for planning an evidence-based plan or for managing. So social epidemiology is giving me that technical support of evidence-based planning and also which is a very first step for administration. So I have chosen epidemiology as my preference.
And your third preference. So let's say if you are not getting selected in hospital administration, and you are getting selected in this course, health administration. So what is your opportunity cost? I mean, what will you miss, like if you are not getting the hospital administration course?
The only thing is about the interior behavior of the hospital about the marketing. Maybe you have some sort of business that is dealt only with the hospital, but majorly health administration is also giving me the required skill and the prospects for me to deal with an organization and also managing any healthcare industry, be it organized hospitals or insurance or a government agency, anything. So only thing I think I'll be missing is the interior functioning of a hospital as a whole.
Okay. So can you tell me, these days we are talking about lots of mismanagement in terms of COVID-related responses from the government. So can you tell me, what were the thing that you think, what were the steps or strategic steps that you think that the government could not do in well-managed way? Or how health administration could have been helped? Health administration does help. But what is the missing part of health administration that from the government side, which basically exaggerated the side effect or disaster of the COVID?
So firstly, government has taken very good step in the first wave management, because with the limited resources, with stringent lockdown, we were able to increase the capacity, and first wave was well managed, I would say. But being the second wave, the mismanagement was done despite experts saying there is an inevitable second wave. We could not develop the capacity, be it oxygen or hospital capacity increasing or vaccination. It was not done in a consistent way and the capacity was not increased. This was a mismanagement, I would say. In case of health administration, this is where health administration plays a role. Making maximum utilization from limited resources and looking into future prospects and coming out with innovative strategies and quick decisions. So this is where we missed. So health administration, we can, with the guidance from healthcare professionals, we can make strategies for emergency preparedness, especially because they have an insight into the trends of and pattern of the disease. Because this is epidemiology also says this, there are many waves that can occur.
Tell me, what do you suggest? Because even the scientists are saying that third wave is also inevitable. It will come for sure. So what kind of suggestion or strategic initiatives that you would suggest to the government to tackle the third wave of corona?
Very first thing is not to give relaxations on the COVID appropriate behavior, because that is what has done we faced in the second wave when there were many crowding, overcrowding, everything was alert. So that should be done. Overcrowding or COVID appropriate behavior should be managed, very first thing. And next, hospitals should focus on increasing the capacity to manage the people. And as many people are predicting, though it is not evidence-based, that children could be affected. So pediatric wards have to be managed to accommodate children along with their attenders, looking into their precaution safety. And also oxygen capacity. Hospitals can have portable oxygen generating plants or oxygen storage capacity. Everything can be increased along with vaccination being consistently increasing to cover maximum number of people.
Okay. So I'll now tell me, since last 1.5 years, we are mostly focused about the COVID and corona related diseases. So what other diseases that you see that must be tackled with the same, not only, not same, but with priority, which may causing lot many death or health damages in society? So what are the other things that you would like to?
Sir, apart from COVID, there are two kinds. One is another communicable disease and a non-communicable disease. In communicable, I would say tuberculosis and acute diarrheal diseases are causing a lot of deaths in India. And in non-communicable diseases, all the non-communicable diseases, because 60% of the deaths in India, according to National Health Profile 2019, is from the non-communicable diseases. And this is also somewhere we have been lacking, because of course we have many health programs for non-communicable diseases, but we need more people awareness and community participation in this. If not, this could also cause a silent epidemic, non-communicable diseases.
Okay, one last question I'll ask to you. Apart from clinics that government provides, what are the other health infrastructure that government has?
apart from clinics.
Yeah, like primary, secondary, or tertiary health center. These are the most clinical aspect of health infrastructure. Yes. What other type of health infrastructure government has?
Apart from clinics, there are many health programs. Like in case of services, government has initiated many health programs, be it Ayushman Bharat Health Insurance Scheme or addressing communicable reproductive maternal health care services. It is setting up many CAMs or separate centers for these non-communicable, like NCD clinics, NCD centers, and health and wellness centers. All these have been established to take healthcare to masses and to have a broader coverage. So apart from PHCs, community health centers and tertiary, so health programs and services.
So do you know about Anganwadi?
Yes, sir.
So what happens in Anganwadi?
Anganwadi has been established from the Integrated Child Development Service in 1978. This is for the early childhood and infant care, and also a care for adolescents and maternal and lactating mothers. So we have one Anganwadi for 400 to 800 population, where there is supplementary nutrition given to children 0 to 6 years and the adolescents. And there is immunization program, health education, reference services, and also supplementary nutrition, health and health education and sanitation, nutrition for adolescents. All these are taken care of by the Anganwadi workers.
Okay. Chalo, thank you. So, matlab, it was a short interview because I did not have to ask twice for a thing that I want to know, you know, or for any criteria. So the question that I've asked was well answered. So many of the times short interviews are like quite accurate. And so,
so did you make it simple just to make us comfortable? No.
I didn't make it simple. I was not very tricky in the asking question, but I asked you vague one and an open-ended one just to know that how do you define such a vague term in small or shorter way, or in that can give you in a structured way. So as far as marks are concerned, I am not being modest, so you can get little more than that also, but still it is like 86 plus, okay, out of 100.
Definitely not.
नहीं सच में 86 प्लस नोबडी कैन गिव यू लेस मार्क्स देन दैट, क्योंकि मैं तुम्हें बताता हूँ व्हाट इज द रेशनल हियर. सो इन प्रेजेंटेशन इन नो वे आई कैन गो बिलो 18 आउट ऑफ 20, है ना. इन कंटेंट, बिकॉज यू हैव टोल्ड मी लॉट मेनी थिंग्स, लाइक अपार्ट फ्रॉम योर क्लिनिकल एक्सपीरियंस, है ना, देयर आल्सो देयर वाज लॉट मेनी ऑफ कंटेंट. सो ऑल दोस क्वेश्चंस वी आर हैविंग some extra data, some extra fact which was there to suffice the your answer, hai na. So the content part, hai na, I've been modest, or I've been strict in marking, so I gave you just 15 marks in that. But again, here I could have given you 18 marks also, hai na. That depends upon the teacher's mood also, that but I kept it 15 only. Your career goal or career ambition was quite clear with all the questions that I have asked, hai na. So again, I have been modest here. Not modest, sorry. I've been strict here, or maine 16 hi diya tumhe, and it could have been 20 also. The last is analytical, the way you have compared the entire all the three courses, you know, and other things that you have. I don't remember the question, but there was also an analytical based question, and again, the criticize on government's attempt to deal with COVID, or for the strategy for the next wave. No, for all these analytical, I could not give less than 18. No, so 18 hai. Phir subject knowledge mein, I had to ask a different question in last mein, other than clinic, what other infrastructure that government is having. So ye subject knowledge, sab cheez mein tumhe achha hi marks mila, so it cannot go below 86. Samajh rahe ho na meri baat? So ab tumhe jo feedback wali baat hai, wo to ho gaya, but tumhe aur kya karna chahiye? Tumhe aur अपने दिमाग को और शांत रखना चाहिए और स्ट्रक्चर करना चाहिए, क्योंकि लास्ट टाइम से यू आर बेटर स्ट्रक्चर्ड, हमारे आंसर्स भी बेटर फ्रेम हो रहे हैं, तो पैनिक नहीं होंगे ना, तो और बच्चे अच्छा कर पाओगे. अगर थोड़ा भी टेंशन नहीं लोगे, इफ यू फील एलिजिबल, तभी तुम एलिजिबल हो, डिस्पाइट ऑल दोस कैपेबिलिटी, ऑल दोस स्किल्स, ऑल दोस नॉलेज यू हैव, इफ यू डोंट फील एलिजिबल तुम नहीं हो एलिजिबल है ना. सो व्हेन यू फील एलिजिबल एंड व्हेन यू सी समवन जो इंटरव्यूअर है उनको पैनल के उनके क्वेश्चन को ध्यान से सुनते हो उस तरह से जवाब देते हो व्हिच वी यू वर डूइंग हियर. अगर तुम वहां पे भी करोगे क्योंकि यहाँ पे तो चलो ठीक है अब नाउ वी हैव इंटरेक्टेड विद मी लॉट मेनी टाइम्स तो थोड़ा वो डर भी कम हो जाता है. बट वहां पे पैनल होंगे दो तीन ऐसा हो सकता है ठीक है दो अलग अलग सिस्टम से थोड़ा सा अलग माहौल हो सकता है. तो उस केस में भी तुमको यही कंपोजर बनाए रखना है इसी तरीके से अपना आंसर करना है. तो इसलिए अब तुम्हें कंटेंट पे हम नहीं कुछ वो करेंगे बस अपने मेंटल कैपेबिलिटी को डेवलप करो. फाइंड योरसेल्फ एलिजिबल फाइंड योरसेल्फ वर्थ फॉर द कोर्स फाइंड योरसेल्फ वर्थ फॉर द नेशन फाइंड योरसेल्फ डूइंग समथिंग वेरी ग्रेट फॉर द नेशन विद दिस कोर्स है ना. नॉट वेग वन कि हमारा ऐसे ही मैगजीन में छप रहा है नाम ऐसा नहीं मतलब समथिंग यू आर डूइंग वर्थ जो जितने भी अभी तुमने फेस किया है अपने फैमिली रिलेटेड इश्यूज और कई सारे हेल्थ इश्यूज लोगों को भी फेस करते देखा है तो तुम समडे यू रियलाइज कि आफ्टर 15 ईयर डाउन द लाइन आई विल नॉट लेट दिस हैपन अगेन है ना. तो इस तरह का एक अंदर से कन्विक्शन लेके आओगे तो अपने आप ही हर चीज कॉन्फिडेंट हो जाएगा हर चीज सही हो जाएगा ठीक है.
Sir, an extemp four, is it mostly subject related or can there be general questions?
Subject related ही होगा है ना.